conference will now be recorded.
You can see my screen, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, right. Here. No, new share. So, I assume we were just talking about formatting and everything. So, we have to talk about some three things. Okay. So, these concepts, right? By any chance, have you tried these? Trend line, forecasting, reference line in Tableau?
No.
Oh, okay, no problem. Let me teach you. These things, right? The trend lines, forecasting, maybe forecasting, reforecasting. But other than forecasting, the other four concepts, it will look good if you try on a scatter plot. It will work on other charts too, okay? But it will look neat on the scatter plot. So let me give an example of scatter plot. As far as Nikon sales, profit, maybe or subcategory. Category. So I'll look for a scatter plot. So trend lines, right? When you right click, you'll find something called trend lines, show trend lines, or you can go to this analytics tab. There is a tab here in the analytics, and here you might be finding called trend line.
Okay.
I'll say linear trend line.
Analytics.
Analytics tab, yeah. And then put to linear. Near data. Like this is the data source.
Where is that?
Near data here. Can you see it?
Okay.
Yeah. You may not have not touched it, but today's the day we're going to talk about it. Okay. So it was existing there, but we didn't really, might have noticed it happens. It happened even for me. Okay. Yeah. So this, right, generally is nothing but it is just a statistical feature of Tableau, or it is just a statistical formula which actually helps us to understand the relationship between the two metrics or two measures. In this case, what exactly it is saying is that as the sales increase, the profit slowly increases. That's why it's showing like a upward facing line.
Okay.
If it was a straight line, it will say that as sales increase, the profit does not vary. So they're not really related. That's what if there's a straight line. If it was a downward facing triangle, downward facing line, it will be like if the sales increase, the profit decreases. Okay. So it's in our case, it's just saying that for subcategory, as the sales increase, the profit is increasing. Let me show you another example where you can see the downward facing line. We'll put a filter on tables. As we have only one value, it's going to stay, but let me add the correct name. So you see, it's downward facing line. Okay, it's because in this particular table's product, right, what they're doing is that as they sell the higher sales product, they were selling it for less profits. Or you can see here that they were actually selling it for a negative profit. You can see, right? That's why this trend line is saying that in this case, as the sales is increasing, the profit is decreasing. Okay. So this trend line, there are different types. Let me show you. I am not so great at trend line, so it's or like statistics. So I'm not so great at statistics. But the thing here is that we will be mostly using it linear trend line. So that will help us to understand like how they're related. So there are other. When I drop drag and drop, you should have noticed there are other models too, but I never really tried them or I never really understood them. Okay. So if you know any statistics or if you know someone who knows statistics, I can help you to show the statistical formula what Tableau uses. So you right click here, trend lines, you'll find something called as describe trend model. Okay. So you cannot really edit the formula of trend line, but you can try different types and these are the formulas what Tableau is doing to create the trend line. But to be honest, I never really understood it. They say that R square is what it is used to draw the line, but I'm not really quite sure how they derive that and how it is used to draw the line. Yeah. But no worries, as far as I tried, even without understanding it, if you just say them that if the line is the facing down, the relationship is opposite, inversely proportional. If it is going up, then it is they are directly proportional. If it is straight, then they are nowhere related or proportional. Just gonna be a straight line, whatever. Like say for example, if it is like I'm just giving an example where you might see a steady line. Consider this as a temperature. Consider that this as your salary. Okay, as the temperature increases or decreases, your salary is not gonna get affected. Okay, salary and temperature are nowhere related. But if it was temperature, and if it was distance covered by you, okay. Maybe if it was very hot, we may not go out. But if it was lesser hot, then we might be going out. Those examples might be related, those metrics. Okay. So this is what I wanted to talk about in the trend lines. Okay. Yeah. So shall I move on? And one more to talk in trend lines, right? Trend line will work when you have two measures. Or let me show you this. Or it should be one date. One date also that should be I'll remove this. So there's too much of information. Something like this. Okay. So what do you see here is something good. I'm just trying to show the table's weekly profit. Okay, here also the line is going down. So when you have two green, this is nothing but either two measures or one day which is in continuous mode. If you select the bottom, it should be continuous, and the other metric, then also you'll be seeing that a trend line. Only in this two case, the trend line node will work. It can be any chart, but remember that there should be two greens and or two greens, either two measures or one date and one measure. Clear? Look like this. Maybe if I remove, right, it's saying that as time goes, the profit is increasing. That's what they are just saying here. Okay, in that case, there we are talking about sales and profit, but here we are talking about time or week and profit. Shall I move on?
What you have done?
I'm just showing for weekly profit. I remove the filter. Weekly filters. Okay. As each week goes, each time goes, the profit is increasing. That's what they are saying in terms of that upward facing. Maybe slowly increasing. It's not, if it was very steep or very sharp, then it would be that as time goes, the profit is very fastly increasing. But here they are saying that it's slowly increasing. So they are saying this gray line, that trend line is saying. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. And moving on. With me, as we are in this chart, so I like to talk about forecasting. So to remove this line, right click trend lines, uncheck the show trend line, that trend line should be gone. Okay, so to make forecasting right, remember for forecasting to work, there should be at least one date and one metric. Forecasting as it says is nothing but it is predicting the future, predicting the dates. So if you go to analytics app, you should be seeing the forecasting. So if it is enabled, you are good to use it. We remove this, we got a date. We put some other metric, maybe I'll put just show you an example. If you go here, the forecasting will not be enabled because there is no date field. Even when you hover, the tab is saying that because there is a there's no data because date cannot be read from the view. So if I put a date, see here, maybe I'll try order date. That is order date. Order date, I'll replace it. Probably I'll go with quarter maybe. And analytics, now you can see the forecast. So either I can write forecast, show forecast, or I can just move and say forecast. So this light blue color line on the light to share what you see is nothing but Tableau is actually predicting. So this data what I have is actually just stopping at 2014 Q4 or okay, but the other 2015 data what you see is Tableau is predicting it. It is just trying to predictor is trying to forecast using the historical data. Okay.
No.
You can actually edit them, so I'll show you. Actually, the blue line, light blue line, is the actual forecasting. The shading is nothing but it's like the called as like a confidence interval, I guess. Okay. So it's just going to say us how high or how low it can go. That's what it is. It's just like that. Okay. So let me show you how to little edit the forecasting. You cannot really edit the formula, but you can again edit the types. Okay. So I'll go here, forecast option. So here you can see the prediction interval. Okay. So and if you uncheck it, that shading will be gone. If you really think you need it, you can just select them. Okay. So most of the cases, I would be personally removing it, but I have seen people using it. So this forecasting thing, right? Tableau is not really a great statistical tool. It's just an add-on feature of Tableau, just to use response from feature like trend lines, this forecasting and stuff. Okay. Give a try on your data. If you're lucky, you're fine. If you are not, then you might be just seeing a steady line, or it will just say no forecast available, something like that. Okay. But it is actually purely based on your data. If there is a seasonality and trend, let's say every April and May there are the high say there's a peak in sales. Every December there is a or always say there's a low value in sales. If like that there is a trend in seasonality, Tableau will surely predicting it. There is no proper trend, and it will be just steady line or no forecast option. Okay. So here, right, few options to talk about. This you can say how long the prediction should be. So mostly it will be an automatic, but if you want, you can say exactly 2 years I want. Okay. There is a small thing called as exactly and until. Okay. So exactly means, let me show you something. I'll talk about the ignore now, but let me show you that. So exactly means, let's say we are at May month, okay? So if I give exactly 2 years, it'll add exactly 2 years to now. So it will stop at 2 years from now. So it should be like May of, let's say we are in 2019. So if 2 years from now, prediction if I'm enabling, so it will stop at 2021 May. That is what? Exactly 2 years. But what it is until 2 years means, so as though we are in May month of 2019, it will predict like this year end and then next year. So it will like kind of, though it is kind of like 1.5 year, it will consider as 2 years. So it will consider till the year end. So this year end and next year end, that's what Tableau will consider as 2 years. Okay. So in this case, I added some value to ignore. So it is just stopping at 2015 Q4. But when I use exactly, you could see the Tableau is kind of going a little further, maybe. Okay, so that is what this exactly and until is. And this thing that we would not be really changing. If you want to really say, I want 2 quarters, I want 3 quarters, 5,000 days like that, you can change the days like that. But we would not be really touching it most of the places. But maybe if I say, I'll say, I want 4 quarters. Or I want only 4 years. Sometimes I change it, but we rarely touch this option. Okay. And next,
so in column section we have quarter, right? Yes. Still, can we show here the forecasting for weekly basis or yearly basis?
It is just saying that how long it is. You cannot convert this quarter to something else unless you right click on that, but if you say week, you have to give some time to maybe like 500 weeks like that. So make sure you're giving a higher value, then it might be helping you out. Get it? So I think 99 is the maximum, I guess. The 99 weeks like that only you can give. Okay. So you can just mostly we'll be using the higher values than the lower values. Okay? But they give an option to edit it actually. Okay? Maybe if I give like 5 years. Yeah. We are not changing this level of what Tableau is doing, but we're just moving like this. Okay. So you could see that looks like there's a trend here. That's why Tableau is trying to predict. It's not, it may not be as accurate as your actual data is. It is might be like as close as possible. Okay. So here aggregate by we can try changing it, but I don't think so it ever worked. So per month, so it is doing it, but still it's not working. So mostly the aggregate will be remain as what is here. So quarter quarter. Okay. Ignore is nothing but, let's say I want Tableau to ignore the last few months. Maybe it could be either the data is incomplete, or let's say we are in the middle of the May month. So it is unfair to consider the May month. So we try to ignore the last 1 month or something. Okay. Or if you think the quarter itself is incomplete, just now the new quarter has started. So quarter is nothing but, as you know, April, May, and June, right? So June is not the, May is also not there. So this quarter is incomplete. So it is okay to ignore or skip this particular quarter. So you can check it, or if you think it's fine to consider, maybe you can give zero. Okay. If there are some null values, you can make Tableau to fill in with zeros. That's what this option they have given. Okay. And here, this is the thing you should be knowing. There are, just like in statistics, in the trend line, I was saying there are different types. Here also they have it. So maybe if I give click on custom, you can see something called trend and seasonality. So I'm not quite sure what they're exactly in terms of statistics terms, but maybe they are different models, like additive is giving like output like this. If I click multiplicative means it will give out like outlook, I mean output like this. So you could try different output to see how you can try different models to see how your output looks like. Okay. So I think this is like addition and this is like multiplication. So you could kind of really see that the line is kind of jumping a lot, but I have not so great at these statistical terms. Okay, so you can just try it. So mostly additive, multiplicative, or multiplicative. So these are three ones which works actually. So you can just try the output, and whichever you think is apt, you can use for your data. Okay. If you really want to read something, you can just click and read, but still, those are like Greek and Latin for me, so I never really understood them. Here also, you can right click and say describe forecast, which actually gives you the technical or statistical values. But as I said, you will not be really able to customize it, only will change the different models. But this is the values which they are using to alpha, beta, gamma, I heard, but never knew what exactly is there. Okay. Shall I move on?
Yes.
Yeah. So next thing, right, like there is something called as reference line, reference band, distribution band. So these are from some small topics in Tableau. Okay. So this also you can try it on most of the charts. So like bar chart, line chart, scatter plot. But see scatter plot, it looks really cool. So I'm going to show you an example using the scatter plot. So let's try sales, profit, and probably I'll go to subcategory. Sorry. Collective property. Scatter plot. So let's start with the reference line first. Okay. So these things, what you see at the top, the constant line, average line, these are like shortcuts for these. Okay. So if you want an average line, instead of drag and dropping it, or right clicking here and say add reference line, you can simply just drag and drop. Say I want a reference line on sales, I want reference line on profit. So all you need to do is just drag and drop this average line. You pick where you want, whether you want in sales, whether you want in profit, or whether you want for both. Okay, can you see the orange shape which I'm trying to show you?
Okay.
Yeah. So if you have multiple, let's say you have a region field here, you have a let's say you have a segment field here. Let's assume that you have a region and segment test, so that instead of one scatter plot, you are seeing multiple small scatter plot. In that case is where you will use this pane and cell, or else we'll mostly be using the table only. Okay. So maybe if you get them, try these two. But for now, I'll just talk about this table. So probably I'll place this here, and you can see two black lines coming, or two gray lines, which is nothing but Tableau's drawing an average sales value line and average profit value line. So using this line, I can make some analysis, like as my sales is high and my profit is high, what are the subcategories there? my sales is low and profit is low, what are the subcategories is there? If your sales is high and the profit is low, what are the subcategories there? So as my profit is high but my sales is low, what are the subcategories there? So basically it's just helping us to understand which product is where or which subcategory is in which region. Okay, so using this I can make lots of analysis. Maybe if you see this, right, I'll put subcategory label. So if you read this, you could clearly see that tables and machines, right, though they are doing high in terms of sales, they are doing very bad in terms of profit. And similarly, if you see copiers, accessories, binders, they are doing good in terms of profit. And whereas papers, appliances, though we are selling it for very less price, we are getting a good profit here. So that's why you're seeing here at the top. They are at the low, though they are in the low sales region, but they are in the high profit region. Make sense?
Okay.
Yeah. So this they call the quadrant analysis. Okay. It'll be using this average line, I have kind of converted my tableau into four quadrants. I'm not sure which is quadrant 1, 2, 3, 4. I assume from here they start 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's good to be there in the 1 and 2 quadrant, but not in 3 and 4. Even 3 is acceptable, but 4 is very bad because both we are selling for very high prices or high sales, we are not making any profit. So it's unacceptable to be in the fourth quadrant. Okay. So this I used using the average line. So let me remove the average line. So hover over it, right click and say remove. Hover over it, right click and say remove. So now what I did was shortcut. It's not the actual way. So I'm going to teach you how to do in the actual way. So drag and drop this and place it on something, or right click and say add reference line. Or you can even find here in the analysis tab, you should be seeing somewhere, where is it? Here in the format you can see the reference. Oh sorry, I take it back. Not here. Maybe it's not here. I take it back. It looks like they don't have it here. They have the forecasting, they have trend lines, but looks like they do not have the reference line here. So in this case, you have to either right click and say reference line. So wherever I right click on profit, I'm doing so in profit, it's going to take by default some more profit. You can change what you want, whether you want on average, you want a maximum value, you want a minimum value. Okay? You can just select them as you change. Tableau is going to draw a line on that. And maybe if you want on a constant value, I can say I want a line drawn on 20,000. So you could see a line drawn on 20,000. Okay. So.
So it is drawing this, like threshold line kind of that.
Yes, exactly. Exactly. It's like a threshold line which says that either above 20,000, this is below 20,000. So visually we are doing it. We can write formula to change the color of it if you remember the other class, if statement I was trying, right? But instead of writing formula, if you show in line, if you show like as a visual thing, it will really help you to understand. And especially the quadrant analysis which I was talking earlier, just few minutes back, right? That for that this line and this reference line will be really helpful. If you want to edit, select on the line, right click and say edit, or click on the axis, edit reference line, this will bring back this window. Okay, so I can change it. Maybe I'll make it to average. If you make average, see this, there's this line coming and the word average is coming. You can kind of change it. Maybe I'll click there and I'll show the value. So the average is 16,847. Or if you click and say none, there'll be nothing shown. Or if you click on computation which is shown, or if I want I can customize it. So I'll type it as average dot. Maybe if you click this arrow, you can that you can make tableau to show the value or field name which is the sales or profit value. Maybe something like this I can do. Average 16,847. Or if you want, I can add the field name or field name. So the average profit is this much. This kind of takes up the space. So I personally try to go with the value, or worst case I might go with the computation. These two is what I use a lot, value and computation, or even I'll use none. I personally don't use custom much, but for you, if you really need, you can try that. Okay. And here line only, if I, there is something called this confidence interval. So Tableau saying, it is just gonna make 95% of the average and below that. It's just like the confidence interval or the prediction interval, what we were seeing in the prediction. We're just saying that average can be this much percent also, this much also. But mostly, we'll stick with the line only. And if you want, you can customize the formatting of the line. So I can just say, I want dashed line, I want in red color. So I can just change it. Okay. This option, fill above, fill below. You can make tableau to color the above part and below part. I'll show you that. And the below part will be in color. So something like this. Did you okay? You can change it. Okay. And the last option here I want to talk is that this show recalculated line for highlighted or selected data points. So let this be selected. So if you see, when I select on few things, it's there. I'm selecting only the top four values or five values. Okay. Select even the top layers. I'm pressing control and selecting them. So if I select them on the selection, what is the average? So if there's an average line for the whole data, the average length for this selection, what I'm making. So Tableau is kind of dynamically computing your average for the average profit for the subcategory. Yeah, make sense.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
If you do not want this option, you can right click on the line, edit it, and uncheck that this small option, which is show recalculate line for highlighter. Uncheck it and give OK. So here, if you select, I think it's going to change. You can see the average line is not really changing, and it's select only these 3 points. Okay. So that's it to talk about on the reference line. Okay, shall I move on?
Yeah.
Yeah. Next thing, right? Reference band. So either I can just drag and drop it and then do it, or I can right click and say add reference line, and then change this to band here. Okay, so as I already have a line here, let me undo it. As I already have a line here, I can convert this line itself into band. So right click, edit that band. And so instead of this option, you just click on band. We are converting that line itself to band. And you could see that probably as I don't have really any dimension here. So entry table per pane per cell will not make sense. It will be just the same. Okay, so I'm not really changing it. But technically, it is entire table as there's nothing here. Okay. So here, if you see that band from a band to, you can just earlier what we had only one line. Okay. Now what we have is like you have like from region to region. So let's try like from average to maximum, draw a line. Like there'll be two lines drawn, and also it will be shaded actually. Like if I'm right, the line is actually not there. Okay. Let's so the line also will make it a red line again. Fill color also, I can change it however I want. The basic idea is that reference line was just one line. Reference band is like you can give from and to. You can even have a constant value. Maybe I'll give, yeah, from average till 40K. Something like that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So as a change, you can see it is not really shading the above area, below area, but it is getting the exact area what I'm saying. Okay, so these labeling option is exactly same like what is we saw in line. You can remove show the values, or you can remove it if you don't want. But the basic idea is you're drawing two lines with the region shaded. That's what this reference band is about. As the name says, band, it's going to be thick where you see the from and to. Okay.
Okay.
So that's it to talk about on reference band. Okay, so next thing, right, there is something called as distribution band. Let me use the same line, so I'll just jump to distribution band. Distribution here, there are too many options, but the one option which we use a lot is this. Click on this quantiles, you'll find something called four. Like what we're saying is that we are asking Tableau to split your chart in four parts. Okay, so I am converting it as four. You could see Tableau saying is lower quartile, median, upper quartile. Okay. Maybe if I edit this option, right, maybe I'll click on this fill above, fill below, and I'll give the color as maybe this tan green option. Okay. So what you're seeing here is that this green region, this orange, like yellow, orange, like if you give OK, right, it will come. Okay, if you see this region, there are tableau is converting to 4 value. So how it is converting is that median is nothing but the center value. So based on the value of each subcategory, tableau find which is the center value. So it will divide in two parts, and again, based on the value of the upper part, it will find a median middle value or the median value. It will again draw the line. Okay, so it is just converting the upper into two half, and again the lower also, the lower median part, it will again find the center value and draw the line. So this way, it is converting into four half. So what exactly is happening is that this helps me to understand that this is making highest profit, this is making the lowest profit, this is like below average profit, and this is like above average profit, or technically to say, it's not average but it's median, so middle value. So it's above middle value, it's below middle value, it's very low, it's very high. So this way I can clearly say that copiers, accessory, paper, phones are doing very great in terms of profit, but whereas labels, supplies, bookcase, machines, tables are doing very worst in terms of profit, and the middle ones are doing okay, just like little above and little lower. Get it? So this they call it as quartile. Using distribution band, I'm creating a quartile so that I can just understand which is my best product in terms of profits, best and worst products, subcategory to be precise. Get it? We are edited. If you think the terms are not really acquired, you can just click none, or if you want, you can see the value. But the thing is this, this whole coloring is the thing. So I'm not using one line. Actually, if you see, technically there are four lines, like, or maybe one, two, three, three lines are there. So reference band can have only one from and to, but whereas this distribution band can have like a distribution, like technically as the name says, we're just trying to understand how the distribution is. So the top distribution, these products are there, and the lower distribution, these products are there. Okay. So last option is box plot. It's nothing but it is for this chart. So when you use this chart, Tableau will automatically use this box plot. So I'm not really touching it. So I really want to talk about these topics. So these here, and let me remove this. Right click and say remove. So instead of adding reference line, you can use for quartiles. Use this median with quartiles. I'll put on sales this time. I'll just edit it a little bit. I'll maybe click on uncheck the symmetry. The symmetry is not really acquired. Symmetry means it will try to shade the same color for both sides. And if you click on reverse, the color will be reverse. So we don't really use this option. Fill above, fill below, tan green. You can even try this top light, but it will be very bright, too bright for the screen. So I personally don't use this. If you're fine, use it. But use tan green, that would be really better. It's like brown, orange, yellow, then green. Looks a little dull and neat too. Mm-hmm. Okay. So this is the concepts which I want to talk in those topics. Fine?
Yeah.
Shall I move on, or any questions on this?
Yes.
And last point to add here, like I like to add here, you can have only one distribution band at the time. If you have another also, it will not be really visible. So remember that point. Maybe that's reference line, reference band, you can have multiple. That's totally okay. But distribution band, only one can be visible at the time. If you try something also, maybe I'll try for profit. So maybe I'll edit it. It'll just overlay, or it'll just go and spoil things. So we actually have two distribution band, but only one I can see, because the one is kind of overlaying on the other. So use only one reference band at the same time. Okay, I mean distribution band at the same time. Yeah, clear? So moving on. Like one interesting topic in Tableau, very small topic, but interesting one. Okay, Viz in tooltip, which is nothing but chart inside a tooltip. Okay, that Viz word is nothing but it's a short form for visualization. You might have heard it if you are reading something about Tableau, if you're trying to Google something about Tableau, you might be people using the word Viz. It's nothing but visualization inside the tooltip. Okay, so till now, what we were seeing is that you are creating a chart But what I'm going to show you is now, you know that this box is called tooltip, right? This whenever hover over it, I see tooltip. Yeah, inside
Yes.
the tooltip, I can create another chart. I can place another chart to be visualized. Okay, so let me remove this quartile. Let me use the same example. But what I'm going to do is that I'll go inside a new sheet. I'll create a chart for product name. Maybe I'll have product name. I'll have sales. I'll sort it. Maybe I'll make the value to come. And probably I'll color it by profit maybe. This I'm just trying out something. Like a simple product level chart, sales and profit may. Okay. So I'll go back to sheet 16. I'll click on this tool tip. I'll just press enter, enter. Here in the insert, find the sheets. Okay, so I'm saying table to sheet, insert sheet
okay.
17, which is the sheet which I created now. Okay, so if you want, you can change the height and width, but for now, I'm not changing anything, I'm just leaving as it is. And I'll give okay. So, what is happening is that you feel that nothing happened, but we edit on tooltip, right? So, when you hover over a particular mark, a particular circle, you can see a small chart coming inside the tooltip. So, as it's a very huge list, Tableau is not really showing the everything, but still is showing you the top products on that particular subcategory. It is not showing all the values. If you see, right, as I move my mouse, the bar color is changing, or the bar products are changing. Okay, so what I see now here is nothing, but I'm making Tableau to show on the subcategory what I hover, it's showing the top products. It is sorted in terms of sales, and it is colored in terms of profit. So I can just see what is the products inside that particular subcategory. So if you see these tables, all the products, top products are doing very bad profit. That's why it's an orange in color. Okay. So this is one cool feature of Tableau which was added very recently.
So can you show it once again? How
yeah.
to go this for this?
Yeah. You are clear with the making the chart, right? Yeah, product,
yeah.
sales and profit. Okay. So you go to sheet 16 in
okay.
the chart where you're gonna place it. Click on tooltip. And wait, let me reset it. Okay. Click on tooltip.
Insert.
Maybe go here, insert, sheets, and then select the sheet which you want. Maybe I'll go sheet 17 and give okay. When you hover, you will see the chart. So Tableau is automatically filtering out for the yeah.
Automatically filtering that sheet 17, right?
Yeah, it is filtering it. So if you go to sheet 17, you will find Tableau is adding a filter. I did not add any filter. Tableau is calling it as tooltip filter, tooltip subcategory. So as you hover over each of the marks, Tableau will be automatically changing the filter there. Maybe you will not want to see it visually, but it is technically doing it for you. Okay.
Okay. Now I provided one summary detail drill down report.
Mm-hmm.
When we create the action links, it will show right the detailed report name and all, it will be shown right in the tooltip when we click on it. In that case, is it possible to add some visualization in that tooltip instead
yeah,
of the file name?
Yeah, you can actually do, you can try like that something. Or maybe what I'll suggest is that instead of imagining like a detail and drill down table, right? So instead of having a drill down, you can actually pretty much, if you think there's a chance of showing the drill down inside your tooltip itself, you can try it. So maybe the tooltip can be this high width. I never really tried high. Maybe I think let's try 700 700. So you have this big space actually. Okay, so you can pretty much we show the detail table here. Maybe they cannot really hover over the bars here. So it's like a static chart, maybe not static chart, but it's like a chart where you cannot again place the mouse to understand the tooltip of that chart. But if you think you're going to show a table, or if you're going to show some bar chart like this, you can even try your drill down to be shown in your this tooltip itself. So which looks really cool, and which saves their time to. Instead of them to going and clicking on something, if they click here, they can see, okay, these are my top production phones. Okay, these are the top production copiers. Like that, they can understand very well. Okay.
Suppose this means like when we create the action links, it will move from if we click on any subcategory, it should go to the product and it should display all the products related to it and then sales, right? So instead of creating the action links, that will work same as this one, right? If you add it,
you have to use action thing actually. So this tool tip is just like bringing another chart here. So this does not really create your action filter. So you have to create action filter if you're going to use a die. Let's say you want a detail and master report, master and detail report. If you, when you click on it, it will go to detail. If you use this, it's not going to really add you an action filter. You have to do it separately. But this will nothing but in a tool tip, it will show a chart. That's what this is. It's not going to do anything more or lesser than that. Make sense? Did I answer your question? Yeah, so if you click now, it's not going to take you to the product.
Can you,
it's just going to be staying.
Can you
there.
Create one once like action link for this from subcategory to sales?
Okay.
I have a doubt on
that. Yeah. Maybe I'll go to dashboard and do it. It's good to, even if it is a one sheet, it's good to use that in a. To use in a dashboard, so automatic.
Okay.
Maybe another dashboard will create for your sheet 17. I'll make it automatic. Okay, so here, right? So when I hover and click, nothing's gonna happen because I have not set any action filter. So I have to set the action filter, obviously. So I have to go to dashboard, actions, add action filter, maybe from dashboard 2 to go to dashboard 3. And I'll select show all values and give okay. So you have to do your regular also. There's no change on that. But the one good thing is that you can kind of give like a preview of your products. It's like a preview.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe if they want to see the full list, if they click, they can go here and they can see the full list here. I clicked on that.
What
I clicked
is
on that.
Yeah, I created one action link and that has come in the tooltip, that filter name and all, action link name and all has come in the tooltip.
Then if the name is coming, then I assume that you should be using menu here. Okay, so if it is menu.
Menu.
So if you click, it's actually it is showing below, I guess. Let me make this chart a little bit smaller. It's affecting things. So menu we rarely use it, but if you really want to use that option, I don't stop you from using it. So can you see this filter one? This is what that link is like. So you cannot really replace this. You are using filter, you cannot really replace it, but at least you can see the, you can show the preview here. So maybe if I click on
the
filter
thing
one,
is like instead of that filter name,
okay,
then we have the two drill downs. When we have two drill downs, two filters.
Mm-hmm.
Conditionally, is it possible to enable? If I click on the product, it should go to the some dashboard. And if I click on, suppose if we have another dimension, subcategory. If I click on subcategory.
I get you. I can imagine what you're trying to say.
Do we have?
I don't think so. We can do that.
Yeah.
It's just like a small image shown in your tool, but a dynamic image, but. I don't think so. You can use this as a link to go to different sheets. I doubt it. You have to use.
For time being, can you remove that visualization in the tooltip?
Tooltip, okay. Let me reset it. Okay.
Okay. Okay. Now, can you please add the action links?
Okay.
Filter you have already added.
Yeah.
One more link can you please create?
So okay, add action. Maybe I'll go to dashboard one. I don't know what exactly dashboard one, but let's give a try.
Yeah.
Okay, on menu. Okay.
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 So we are clicking on subcategory appliances and it is showing filter one and filter two, right? So we will provide some. So if I click on subcategory, user may would like to go to see all the products, filter one is, and filter two might be some other thing.
Yeah, they have to click on that.
So
they have to click on filter one or filter two only. No other
is
way.
It possible to add, is it possible to add any symbol or any visualization kind of that before filter one name? Before filter
you
one
can
name.
Rename, you can rename it. That's all we could actually do. Maybe I'll say filter subcategory or filter or drill down to. That's all you could. All you can do is just rename it. Nothing else you can do. Drill down to dashboard
it,
three. Dashboard you can. I don't think so. You can edit or maybe one thing I can teach you is that if you click on this arrow, you can actually substitute the subcategory value that maybe for like that. Drill down to dashboard three for it will substitute the subcategory value. That's it. I don't think so. You can do anything else over this renaming thing. So as I renamed it, when I click, you will see a name like this. Drill down to dashboard for the substituting the subcategory. That's all it can do. Maybe you can try like this if you think. Maybe if you want this for subcategory and this for product, you can try changing the, you can try renaming it and adding that particular dimension there. But you cannot have a visualization, you cannot have anything else for that link or something to replace like icon or something. Yeah? Get it?
Okay, I got it.
Yeah, that's the only way. Maybe they might add in the future, but for now they have only the name there. It's like a link name, URL name. Okay.
Yeah.
So I'll just undoing it. Let me go back to the chart. So chart here. Okay, there. So whenever the table is not feeling that views not enough, it will say at the bottom view is too large to show. So it will, if you want, you can customize a little. Let me teach you that small thing. Go to tooltip. If you think you don't want Tableau to change the filter, just remove this or this all fields and give OK. So when you hover over all the things, the filter will not be really applied. So if you see that first product is Canon even for accessories, first product is even Canon for the copiers. It means that Tableau is not really applying the copiers as a filter there. Because I removed that filter here.
Okay.
If you really want it, either you can type that all fields or the spelling might be confused. So I would suggest remove this and add this back. So the Tableau will automatically add that filter all fields. Or if you want to be specific, you have multiple dimension, you want Tableau to specifically send only value, you can just type that with the exact spelling except hyphen category like that. Okay. So this way, you can kind of customize it a little. In the height and width, you can change the filter. These are the three things you can customize for this ambition tooltip or chart and tooltip. Okay. Yeah, clear?
Yeah.
So that's what I want to talk in this tooltip. Okay. Okay. So this
before last and three topics,
Yeah, go ahead.
Before last three topics, I would like to take some time for 2-3 days. I would like to practice all the assignments, everything, you know, whatever you have mentioned, but I'm not getting time to do.
Sure.
So by the time I reach home only, it will be late. So,
understand.
So, shall we connect back on Friday? Because Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, I will practice.
Okay, shouldn't be a problem. And I was actually suggesting is that, like, I thought like we'll take tomorrow, but still if you want a break, I don't mind it. We can talk about the assignments. So make sure you try everything. If you think the assignments are hard, it's okay, skip it. I'll talk about it. I'll clear the doubts or whatever struggle you have. Don't spend more than 15 minutes on one question. It's like too much, I'll say. Okay, so everything straightforward. If you think there is any doubt on the question, just WhatsApp me. I'll just try to reply it. Okay, so and what I was trying to suggest is this. This best practice is just an oral thing. So even without touching these two topics, I can talk about best practice. So if you are fine, I thought I'll make use of the 5 minutes, or it is just a very small topic only. If you want, I can even talk about later.
Yes.
Now or later?
Okay. Yeah.
Can I talk?
We can continue.
Yeah. Okay. So best practice, nothing but like what are good things you can follow for your, so when you make charts, when you make visualization, what are good things you can follow? That's what I want to talk here. Okay, so the first thing what I can advise is that the colors, okay, the colors, right, try to use established default color. It is actually good, okay, but in case you are forced to change the color of Tableau, don't use bright colors, try to use duller colors. Okay, so it is just best practice, but still, if your client is strong on using brighter colors, like they want a very bright green or bright red, if they really want it, go ahead. But if you are given a choice to select the colors, if you are given a choice to format everything, it's good to use Tableau's default or a duller colors. Maybe if you click here, you can actually see there are too many color palettes there. Maybe you can try them, but still, if you think they are too bright, skip it. The Tableau's this classic 20 is the best, I would personally say, or maybe they have this Tableau 20. These are the duller colors. Earlier it used to be little brighter, okay, when compared to this. So it's good to use this Tableau 20. It's little duller, looks neat, it's good on eyes. So make sure you see to the colors. Okay. So talking about colors, maybe I'll go to a new sheet. I'll just show you real quick and then I'll go with this here. So I'll put product into colors. Okay. So if you see here, there are too many colors. It's just pure confusion. Okay. So it's not really helping us. And also what Tableau does is that after 20 colors, it's going to repeat it. 20 or 16, I assume. Okay. Mm-hmm. You see this blue and this blue has no relationship. So people try to find the relation between the colors. Okay. So they might be thinking, what is the relation between this orange and this orange, but it's purely just coincidence that they have share the same color. It's because of the order. Okay. So don't use colors if you think there are more than 20 values. Color it by something else, maybe. Maybe you can color it by subcategory, or you can color it by category or region, something. But don't color it by the same value which you think has. This will result you more than 20 plus colors. Okay. And even personally speaking, don't color something more than 3 or 4 values. This is just gonna create confusion. So I'll suggest maybe color using category. I think it helps. This is really cool. So you can clearly see how much product in furniture, how much product in office supplies, like that. Okay. So colors, be very careful, because the formatting, whatever you write formula, whatever action filter you do, whatever you do technically, right, that's not going to impress your client. But the formatting, the look and feel is what is going to impress your client. Okay. So whatever we saw in the 80% of the Tableau's career, right, that is not important. The 20%, the formatting, the look, visual is important. So make sure you don't, make sure you impress the right colors and the right things, the formatting and colors. Okay. So that's the important point I can give you. Second thing is that give proper names. Okay. So in this case, as it is training, I did not really give a proper name, but give proper name so that you remember, or your future generation of developers remembers what exactly is this. Okay. So if you say, I can say discount or sales, I can say first order. So this is good. But here I did not really name properly. So this is a bad thing which I did, but still, as it is training, I forgive myself. But the real world, please make sure you give the right name so it will be helpful for you. And this is the name what they will also see in the tooltip. So make sure you give a proper name here. Okay. And last two things which I can give you for the best practice, try to, if you're making even a one sheet, right, try to place it in a one dashboard and hide the sheet. If you right click and say hide all sheets, the underlying sheet will be hidden. So if you see, the sheet 17 is not here because I hide it. Okay. So when you publish it, or when you give a dashboard, you give a charge to your end user, make sure to give us a dashboard and not as a single sheet. Okay. That is also one good practice I can say. And lastly, the best practice what I can give is that this tooltip, right? The title, right? This title, or you can even click on the show dashboard title to give another title. So give the title properly that your end user understand what is there in the view. So in this case, I can see it from here, product name and sales. But if I had given here, or if I had given here, people would have been more happier. So usually, whatever sheet name or whatever dashboard name you give is what will be shown. Maybe I'll just say product details. So what you type here will come here. But still, you can double click and edit it if you want. Maybe instead of sheet name, I can say product details by sales. So you can leave it, or you can even remove it and give OK. You'll see like this. Or if you think this is unnecessary, hide the title, right click, hide title, so it will be gone. Or if you need the title back, undo it, getting it, and you can edit it. Maybe product sales. So my point here is that make sure to give a proper title so that they understand what is that. Okay. So you might feel it is repeating. You hide it one thing. Sorry, I think I should hide. And maybe if you want, you can even hide this name. Right click, hide field labels for rows. Just let this be bad. Don't change the access. But having a proper title will help you to understand. Maybe one chart is fine. Assume you have 4 or 5 chart. They'll be wondering what are you creating. So it's good to create give a proper title, proper name for the dashboard or for the tab, so that they will understand what is really happening. So give proper title for and give proper name for the tabs in dashboard, which you got you work. Okay. So these are the few best practices. Again, there are lots of best practices, you can Google and see it, but I personally feel these 4 are the very important things than anything else. So that's why I'm bringing this and saying to my
friends. How to unhide the sheets?
So right click on that dashboard, maybe dashboard 2, right? Okay. Right click, hide all sheets. If you want to edit or something,
yeah,
you can right click and say unhide all sheets,
no.
Edit them, and then go back here, right click, hide all sheets. So whatever sheets used in that particular dashboard only will be hidden, not the other sheets.
Okay.
Only when you use the sheets in a dashboard, you can hide it. Unless and until you will not be able to do it. So this hide all sheets, nothing will come, but it'll come in dashboards, you can hide it. You can hide even the individual sheets, but assuming that you are hiding that, let's say sheet 12, sheet 13, right? If you go to sheet 12, you can see that hide, you can see the hide option. But if you go to sheet 10, I'll not see that hide option because I have not used the sheet 10 in any dashboard. So remember this one point, that if you're using a sheet in dashboard, you can hide that sheet. Other worksheet cannot be hidden because I have not used in dashboard. Make sense? You can, like, one tip I can give or one trick I can show is that, like, I have hidden the sheet for dashboard 2. So, okay, that's why you are seeing that hide is disabled and unhide is okay. If you want to edit something, click here and click on sheet 16. This small icon, right? This is like called go to sheet. Okay, if you click it, it will take you to the sheet, it will temporarily unhide the sheet. You can edit it. If you go back to dashboard 2, that sheet will be hidden. So this way, I do not have to right click, hide sheet, unhide all sheets. I do not have to do it repeatedly. So all I need to do is just click on this thing, go to sheet. This takes you there, do the changes, whatever you want, change the formula, change the formatting, change the chart, whatever you want, you do it, anything. You can do any customization. Then come back to dashboard 2, that sheet 16 will be hidden. So if you see, you're not really seeing sheet 16 because it is hidden. I've hidden this. Okay.
Yeah.
So with this, I stop my class. Any questions or doubts?
I'll ping you once I'm done with all the assignments, and then we will discuss last how to publish the dashboards, everything.
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Okay. See you on Friday.
Yeah.
What's up?
Thank you.
Thank you.